The Lopez Group of Companies has donated 100 million pesos to the Philippine Transportation Department to be used to convert passenger ships and passenger terminals into temporary quarantine facilities. We'll be discussing this with Jay Santiago, the General Manager of the Philippine Ports Authority. Sir Jay, magandang gabi sa inyo.
Magandang gabi, Tony, and good evening to all your viewers also.
You know, thank you very much for joining us on this special coverage. So 100 million pesos will be divided into converting ships and terminals into quarantine facilities. So yung terminals will fall under your jurisdiction.
Well, the funding support that was provided by the Lopez Group of Companies, no, particularly First Philippine Holdings Corporation, First Gen Corporation, and the Energy Development Corporation, it was all-encompassing. They're giving leeway to the Department of Transportation on how the department could decide to use the 100 million funding support. Mm-hmm. So initially, the funding support will be applied to the retrofitting of the passenger cruise terminal at South Harbor in Pier 15. Mm-hmm. This passenger terminal building will be converted into a COVID-19 treatment facility, which will complement the two vessels that are already docked at Pier 15, which will house quarantine patients, those particularly seafarers who will be coming in and who would have to serve their 14-day quarantine before they're allowed to go home.
Okay. So seafarers, GM, ang supposed to be priority i-house dyan sa Manila South Harbor Terminal?
Yes. Primarily seafarers, because there will be a lot of them coming in. In fact, today there were about 300 or 400 seafarers that came in, and we're expecting a lot more in the coming days and in the coming weeks, those who will be repatriated.
How many, how many beds do you have as a capacity to quarantine people there at the Manila South Harbor Terminal?
Well, the ships, the two vessels, the quarantine vessels, will be able to accommodate a total of 1,100 persons.
Okay.
And then the terminal, the treatment facility, will be able to accommodate 206 beds.
Okay. And yung the facilities that you'll be using, the beds, other medical equipment, where will these be sourced?
Well, the funding support that has been provided by the Lopez Group of Companies will be used to retrofit the terminal. Mm-hmm. And then as for the beds, the Philippine Coast Guard, because this is a joint project of the Department of Transportation, the Philippine Ports Authority, and the Philippine Coast Guard, the Philippine Coast Guard has committed to provide the beds for the facility. And the health workers, the doctors and the nurses, will be primarily Coast Guard medical staff who will man that terminal.
Mm-hmm. How much retrofitting will you have to do for the passenger terminal? And what will that involve? Are you talking about sealing off some areas to convert them into isolation rooms?
Well, the good thing about the terminal, Tony, is that it's the layout is open. Mm-hmm. In fact, we've already mobilized last week and construction will start tomorrow. We should be able to finish the retrofitting in about 7 to 10 days. So we're ready to accommodate patients by April 24.
Okay. And when you say that it's an open layout, that it's actually easier to retrofit, what modifications have to be done to be able to convert it into a proper quarantine facility?
Well, it's already air-conditioned, okay. And it has lots of doors, lots of windows, which are, as far as the health professionals are concerned, they prefer it that way so that there will be fresh air, fresh ocean breeze coming in. The major retrofitting that will be done is that we will have to construct cubicles, 206 cubicles, to be able to isolate each and every patient from each other. There are certain rooms in the terminal already which will be used for the supplies. Mm-hmm. And then the design, it will have an open-air mess hall, mm-hmm. meaning there will be food service that will be available outside the terminal, but under tents. Showers will be outside. in retrofitted containers. And there will also be toilets that are portable.
Mm-hmm. Actually, yung issue na sinabi mo, GM, no, yung lots of windows, lots of doors to let in fresh ocean air, parang medyo hindi ata ako makapaniwala na fresh pa yung ocean air dyan sa bandang bahagi ng South Terminal, South Harbor.
No, you should visit Tony one of these days. we were there last week.
Yeah.
And in fact, even with the architect and the engineers, and they were pleasantly surprised that the air there is fresh now, especially that, you know, we've been in enhanced community quarantine over the past month already.
So the air is actually much cleaner now, you think? It smells better?
It definitely smells better. Mm-hmm. And, you know, if you compare it with the inner city air, air in the harbor is so much better. It's fresher.
Mm-hmm. Okay, well, that's, pardon the pun, a refreshing change. But GM, you know, 100 million, of course, coming from the Lopez Group of Companies. Are there other groups that are also contributing to help the transportation department into retrofitting temporary quarantine facilities?
Well, the vessels that have been provided mm-hmm. are from the To-Go group. They've been able to help us secure these vessels and to, you know, allow quarantine patients to come in and to, you know, to be able to use them.
Mm-hmm.
Some other, insofar as the other projects of the Department of Transportation are concerned, as you know, we've been providing the free bus rides for the health workers.
Mm-hmm.
There have been a lot of groups that have been providing free fuel for the buses, and a lot of people have been providing free meals for the drivers, for the, you know, our people from the land transportation office that are manning the terminals for all of these free bus rides. So a lot of people have been helping. We have been hosting the Department of Transportation Emergency Operations Center, and people have been donating for our operators there, for alcohol, PPEs, water, food. So everybody's helping out.
All right. Well, I'd like to take you up on your invitation to actually go and personally see how you've retrofitted the facilities. But in this case, I'm also under lockdown myself. So I don't know. How about you and your staff? How are you working out? Are you all working from home?
Well, we've as far as the head office of PPA is concerned, we're on skeletal force. But as far as all the ports are concerned, particularly the ports in Manila, it's fully staffed right now, since we haven't scaled down our operations from the time of the ECQ. As far as I'm concerned, we're at the Port of Manila on a regular basis, trying to see to it that the cargoes are free-flowing, and especially with this retrofitting of the terminal, we have to be there daily to make sure that everything works out.
So wala lang problema, GM, with port congestion, because that was something that we were reporting on last week before the Holy Week break.
Well, yes. In fact, I would like to thank you, you know, for helping out in broadcasting the issue. We've been able to improve the utilization a little, but we have to sustain it. You know, we saw that the utilization went down to about 75% before last weekend.
Mm.
And then right after that weekend, I think a lot of, you know, the cargoes weren't pulled out over the weekend.
Yeah.
So it shot up again to about 95%. So what that shows is that if we don't sustain the momentum, we'll eventually end up with full congestion again. So far we're able to manage it, but the problem is, you know, incoming cargoes have come in over the Holy Week.
Mm-hmm.
There's no holiday as far as the cargoes are concerned, but you know, people haven't pulled them out from Thursday till today.
Mm-hmm.
And that has basically brought up the utilization again. So we hope by tomorrow everybody starts coming in and starts pulling out their cargoes again.
All right, we'll check in with you again as this week begins, and hopefully we'll see many of the cargo companies pulling out the shipments from the both the Manila International Container Terminal and the Manila South Harbor. Tama po ba?
Yes, correct. The two major terminals, Tony.
Right. All right. GM Jay Santiago of the Philippine Ports Authority, thank you very much, sir, for speaking with us on our AOT special coverage. And we wish that you and your staff keep safe.